What if there was an art gallery that displayed the raw emotions and feelings of people? People always tend to have a judgmental view towards what they first see, and we thought we could use this idea into developing our game. Would you be interested in joining our gallery tour?
Hello, we are Studio Wonderkey. I'm here to give you a short intro about us before we get into the game. We released the game back in 2015 and have been continuing our creative work throughout the years. The name Wonderkey is a representation of our team, opening up new and fantastic gateways to unexplored ideas and concepts in our games. Hence why our concepts and ideas usually spring up from the unexpected. It started with Twitter, when we saw the word exhibition of emotions. The word exhibition of emotions came from social media when a person expresses their ideas on a certain subject online. People look at said person's opinions or thoughts as if they were watching a display of an emotion. However, the ones that would get the most reactions were usually the ones with a strong negative vibe or someone playing devil's advocate. Being drawn to these concepts, we started to think what it would be like if people were actually visiting a gallery that exhibited people's emotions. So our first approach was a simulation game where we made a museum-like structure and made the characters interact with the art pieces all the while certain motion bars rose and fell. We took this approach inspired by museums in other games, thinking it'd be easier to simulate. But we came across a few problems from the get-go. It did go well with the concept of an art gallery, but the characters' responses were spread too thin and was chaotic. It wasn't a good method to convey the story and narrative we prepared. In order to focus on the conflicts of the audiences, we changed the perspective from the museum to the characters. So our revised design was this. The player will also be seeing the art pieces from an audience's standpoint. We also changed it to where while the curator explained the art piece, the player would be able to see the special character's response, so that the player could focus on the dialogue and theme of each special character's and the artwork. So next we will be talking about the theme and topic of our game. As we mentioned ahead, the word emotion may be too abstract and might not come across that well. So we tried focusing on the aspects of human conflict and problems in our society. For a quick example, let's talk about the Tom and Jerry show. Some people see Tom as the protagonist of the show, while other people see Jerry as the protagonist. Both are valid choices, but it's all in the matter of personal preference and perspective. As such, our game is about several characters looking at certain events from their unique perspective, and the conflict that arises from that shapes our game's story. Just to be completely clear, we do not represent a certain idea or opinion as fact, but rather we are focusing on the "what would you do" aspect of things. We emphasize that there will be a definite ending for the game, but there is no correct ending. So our next video, we will be talking about the characters that will be shaping our game's ending. This is the end of our devlog we prepared for today. Next time, we will be focusing on the characters of our game, which is the game's core premise. If you want to hear more about our game, please like, comment, and subscribe. If you want to hear more about our game, our official social media link will be in the descriptions below. Thank you.